Hello everyone, so in this video we will see what is meant by DO binary decoder. So in previous video I have discussed about DO binary encoder and what are the problems associated with it, block diagram of that one, and why we are studying basically DO binary encoder. Okay, so in this video we will see what is meant by decoder. Okay, so first we are having the block diagram. It's very simple. DO binary signal will be coming here and it is sampled at TB seconds. Okay, so this then it is applied to decision device and then we will be getting the binary data output. So the binary data output will be the what we have transmitted or given as an input to the encoder block. Okay, so TB equal to sampling time interval. So TB is the sampling time interval, means it is a time interval between two bits. If it is 1 millisecond, then for every 1 millisecond the switch will be opened and closed. So it will be open and closed within 1 millisecond. Then it will be taking one voltage. Basically the input DO binary signal means it is voltage, either positive or negative voltages. And if we are having positive voltage, then it will be given to the decision device, and based on the algorithm it will be decoded as either 0 or 1 because we are having only two output levels. Okay, that's about decision device and decoding circuit. So possible inputs are -1 and +1. The outputs will be depending on CK, CK can have three values, I have said in previous video. So +2, -2, 0, these are the possible three values. When the CK is +2, output will be +1. When the CK is -2, output will be 0. And if CK is 0, output bit is the complement of previous bit. This is to be noted that when the CK is 0, the output will be the complement. So if the previous output is 0, then the CK will be 1. If it is 1, then it will be 0. Depending on the previous bit, the output will be decided if the CK equal to 0. This concept I will be explaining in the next page. Okay, let us go to the next example of the DO binary decoder. So how the signal will be decoded. Okay, so example of decoder, BK equal to 00. So for simplicity I have written the same example which I have said in the my previous video. Okay, so BK, this is the input signal which we will be assuming. So this is our data input 00110101. So AK is polar representation of this one. 0 is written as -1 and 1 is written as +1 as it is. This is the polar representation. Then this is the delayed version. So the D dot dot which I have written here, this is the assumed bit. Okay, so this is shifted here, this is shifted here, this is shifted here, like this. For every bit we have shifted the AK -1 by 1 bit of AK. So this is transmitter or encoder output. So encoder, what we will be getting, CK equal to addition of this one, -1, -1, -2, -1, -1, -2, 1 plus -1, 0. So like this we will be getting CK. Now coming to our actual part of this video, that is receiver or decoder output. What will be the output, binary output, depending on this one. Okay, so for getting +2, we will be having our the input bits as 1 1. As we can see here, this is 1, this is 1. When both are equal to 1 only, then we will be getting 1 as the output. So that's why if the CK is equal to +2, then the output bit will be written as 1. So that's the algorithm of this DO binary decoder. And when the CK is -2, so when we are getting CK as -2, either it is -1, -1, so okay, everywhere it is -1 itself. And -1, where it is coming? It is coming from this one. So when the BK is 0, then only we are getting AK and AK -1 as -1, -1. And due to this AK, these two bits, we are getting this bit. So indirectly this bit is representing this one. So that's why if it is -2, then output is 0. This is pointing here. And if due to these two bits, this bit will be affecting. So this is indirectly affecting to this one. When it is plus 2, then output will be 1. Plus 2, output will be 1. So we want to get the same output now. That's why we are writing the algorithm like this. But for the 0, it is the other case. Okay, output will be complement of previous value, because see, we are 0, we are getting 0. So 0, when we will be getting either minus 1 plus 1, or we are getting for plus 1 or minus 1. So we can't decide whether the output bit is 1 or 0. Okay, so that's why we are taking complement of the previous value. So how will we write this? Minus 2 means it is 0. So for minus 2, we are writing it as 0. And this is also minus 2, 0. For 0, we will be writing the complement of previous value. So this is previous value for this input. So its complement will be 1. For 2, we are directly writing as 1. For 0, its complement. Okay, so complement is 0. For 0, again, its complement. For 0 again, its complement. So minus 2, we will be writing it as 0 directly. And for 0 again, we will writing its complement. And this is how the binary decoder output will be written. And I hope you understood about this CK concept, that is a decoding algorithm, why we are writing plus 2 output as 1, for minus 2 output as 0, and for 0 output as complement of previous value. But by writing like this, we are facing two issues. That is, error propagation will happen and polarization error will be introduced in this type of decoding. And those two concepts I will be explaining in my further videos. And bye for now. If you like the video, please leave a thumb. And if you have not subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe. Thanks for your support. Thanks for watching.